Hello and good morning to everyone. We are going to solve this question. This was asked in December 2015 and it was all about formulation and solution of the given linear programming problem. So what is being asked in the question? We will try to solve this question as of now. So a tailor working on contract has to make two clothing items A and B. So the tailor is going to make two types of clothing items A and B. Okay. He can make 5 of each item in an hour and wishes to produce at least 25 items in a day. So he will make at least 5 items of A. Okay, and 5 items of B, because he wishes to make 5 items each items in an hour and wishes to produce at least 25 items in a day. Now he can get at the most 16 meter square of material needed to produce them. It takes 1 hour to process 2 meter square of A and 1 hour to process 4 meter square of B. Okay, so we can sense that everything is given in some kind of hour about the clothing item. One more thing that is given about this question is he gets 1 unit of profit after spending 1 hour on item A and 5 units of profit after spending 1 hour on item B. So some condition is also given about the profit. He can't spend more than 5 hours on item A. How many hours should he spend making each item to maximize the profit? So the difference is not how many items. In earlier questions or in any kind of LPP questions, it was always about how many. It was always about how many atoms. Okay. It used to be. One second. It always used to be how many atoms. Okay. How many atoms was the question. But here it is not how many atoms. It is about how many hours. Okay, how many hours, if you can see, will he spend on each item to maximize the profit. So from the statement we can identify how to write that thing. Okay, so we have to write our think of our decision variable. So we will write at x1 be the number of hours, okay, to make atom A. Okay, he will spend number of hours to be spent to make atom A. And similarly we will write let x2 be the number of hours to be spent to make item B. Okay, so we have suppose something on the basis of hours. Now what is the next thing that is coming in the question? He has to make 2 clothing items A and B. So we have assumed that he will take x1 hours for A and x2 hours for B. He can make each of 5 items. So he can make 5 of x1 and he can make 5 of s2, and he wishes to produce at the minimum, he will want 25 items. If he can make more than 25 items, he'll be more than happy. So this is my equation number 1. He can get 16 meter square of material. Now this condition is all about, this condition we can sense, this is all about hours he will spend. Okay, he wishes to spend how many hours? 25 hours in a day. Okay, and he can wish, he can spend at least 5 hours on item A and 5 hours on item B, and he wishes to spend at least 25 hours. So this is hours constraint. Now we'll get to the next type. What is our next type? We need to think about it. Okay, he can get at most 16 meter square of material needed to produce the item. It takes 1 hour to process 2 meter square. So if it is taking 1 hour to process 2 meter square, so how many hours is he going to work? He's going to work x1 hours. So x1 hours into 2 will be the total number of hours he'll be spending, right? Because he is taking 1 hour to process 2 meter square. So for x1 hours, how many meter square he will take? x1 into 2. Okay, and he is taking 1 hour to process, if we can see, he is taking 1 hour to process 4 meter square of B. So in this way, x2 into 4, right? X2 into 4. And how much material is he having? He is having at most 16 meter square of material. So he cannot go beyond 16 meter square of material. So this second condition is all about material constraint. Okay. Now the third we can see, he can't spend more than 5 hours on atom A. So he also knows that he can't spend more than 5 hours. So this is not hours. This first one was about how many atoms. So hours, rather than saying hours, we can even say this is an item constraint. Okay. So this first one is atom constraint. Second one is material constraint. And the third one is, this one is hours constraint. And the hours constraint is only for atom A, because he can't spend more than 5 hours on atom A. Okay. So these the things are mentioned. These are the things. Last, what is being said is he gets 1 unit of profit after spending 1 hour on atom A and 5 units of profit after spending 1 hour on atom B. So how many hours is he going to spend according to our objective function? Z, he is going to spend x1 hours. So how much profit he is getting for 1 hour? 1 unit. So x1 hours, he will get x1 into 1. And how many hours is he going to spend for atom B? X2 hours. And how many hours is he going to, how many units is he getting the profit? 5. So this is x1 plus 5x2. This is all about profit. And here also it is said, how many hours should he spend to maximize the profit? So automatically, this Z is all about maximization. This Z is about maximize. Okay. So we have got the conditions. We have actually got the conditions. So we will just write the condition once again for our simplicity. What is being said right now is maximize Z is equal to X1 plus 5X2. And it is being subjected to some conditions where the first condition of atom constraint is 5X1 plus 5X2. Should be at least equal to 25 atoms in a day, and it is being said that x1 2x1 plus 4x2 regarding the material constraint, it should be at most 16. And one more thing that is mentioned is x1, that is R's constraint for atom A, is less than equal to 5, and we also know that x1 is greater than equal to 0, and we also know that x2 is greater than equal to 0. So this is the condition that is being stated to us. Okay. Now what do we need to do? We need to solve this question to maximize the number of hours he should spend to maximize the profit. Okay. So now what we will do is, I'll just take a diagram that I've already made. What I'll do is I'll just copy this thing. So that we can directly use this table. Okay. We are just going up and we are just looking at the question. So now we need to solve this question. Suppose we need to solve this question by simplex method. Now what we are seeing here in this question, what we can see here in this question, 1 is greater than equal to, 1 is less than equal to, again 1 is less than equal to. So since seeing the constraint, this is mixed constraint. So if this is mixed constraint, the method that we should use is big M. There is one more method that we can use, but right now we are just seeing big M method. So we are going to use big M method. So how to solve it by big M method? First we have to simplify the inequality by adding some slack variable, or if needed we should also add the artificial variable. So what we will do here is 5x1 plus 5x2, since it is greater than this equation, greater than, so what we have to put, minus s1, okay, is equal to 25. Well, we'll get to the next type. What is the next type? 2x1 plus 4x2, since this is less than, so this will be plus s2 is equal to 16. The third equation will be x1. Again, it is less than. You can see it is less than. So this will also be plus s3 is equal to 5. Now what we can see, that since there are three equations, what was our condition? If there are three equations, there should be three slack variables. T three inequalities, three inequations or inequalities, there should be three slack variables. So since there are three inequalities, 1, 2, 3, there are three slack variables, and it should form identity matrix. But we already know that when there are mixed constraints, some of the slack variable might be positive, negative. Like this slack variable is negative, since whenever there is a greater than sign, we already know greater than equal to sign, we have slack variable to be positive. So if the slack variable is positive, sorry, negative, then in that equation, to initiate the solution, what do we need to add? We need to add a artificial variable. So we are adding artificial variable A1. Only one artificial variable is needed because there is only one equation with greater than equal to constraint. So wherever there is greater than equal to constraint, to initiate the solution in the simplex, which is Big M method, we need at least an artificial variable so we can form an identity matrix. Now what we will do is we will again rewrite Z. So Z will be equal to maximize. What will be it? Z was x1 plus 5x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2, because this won't contribute. But if M remains in the solution, it will impart a huge penalty to the company. So that's why we have taken M, where M is a very, very large integer. Very, very large positive integer, right? So if M is a very, very large positive integer, automatically what will M do? M will impart a big penalty if it remains in the solution. So our purpose is to eliminate the M. If A remains in the solution, it will impart a huge, huge penalty of plus M, okay, which is going to be subtracted. So our objective is to eliminate A, artificial variable A should be eliminated, so the biggest penalty M should get eliminated. If that penalty is there, the company won't be able to get the profit. Suppose the company is going to get a profit of, I'll just note it down for you. Suppose the company is going to get a profit of 10 lakh and 1 million is the value of M. Okay, suppose A1 is only 1. But if this value is 10:6, so we know that there will be a huge loss. It will be a huge negative number for the company, right? It will be a huge negative number for the company. So this will be the loss that will be imparted. And this kind of loss is called as Big M method, or it is also called as, this is the reason we also call this method as penalty cost method. Okay. This method is also called as penalty cost method. So I hope you understood what I was trying to explain. So now the next thing is we need to solve this question. Just write it here for the convenience. This is also called as penalty cost method. Now we'll just take this question. So we need to use these equations. What are the equations? You can see the first equation. So before writing the equation, we will just put the value of the Z here. So what is the Z? X1, X2, S1, S2, S3, and there is one more, which is A1. Okay, now we know what are the values of X1 in the first equation of our constraint equation. It is 5, then again it is 5, then again it is minus 1. This is 0, this is 0, and A1 is 1. Okay, now the second equation, we can see the second equation. That is the second equation. 2, 4, 0, 1, right? So we will write it here. Just go down. So the second equation is 2, 4, S1 is not there, 0, 1. Then again, it will be 0, 0, since there are no S3 anymore. Now for the third equation, what will happen is 1, then this will be 0, 0, then 1, sorry, then again 0, because it is having S3, then 0. What are the RHS? We can even put RHS. What are the RHS value? The RHS value is 25. Then it is 16, then it is 5. So we have mentioned everything. We need to mention coefficients of Z, which are called as Cj. So what are the coefficients of Z? X1 ka coefficient is 1, then this is 5, then this is 0, then this is 0, then this is 0. And this is, you can see the coefficient of A, this coefficient is minus M. And RHS will always have the coefficient which is equal to 0. Okay, so we have written everything. Now, whoever forms the identity matrix, the solution will start with that. The solution will start with that. We can see see 100, right? Then we can see 010. Then what we can see 001. So what will be the sequence? First it will be A1, then S2, and then S3. So these three variables will start our basis solution. What I'll do is, I'll just put the basis variable. Okay, so we'll write here what it is: A1, S2, S3. Then this will be ZJ minus CJ. Okay, how? Now we already know that we can even do it by this way. This is minus M, this is 0, this is 0. Now minus M into 5. Minus M into 5 will be minus 5M minus 1, ZJ minus CJ. So minus 5M minus 1, okay. This is 0, this is 0. So ZJ minus CJ will be minus M minus 1, minus 5M minus 1. So this will be minus 5M minus 5. This will be M, okay. This will be 0. We already know ZJ minus CJ should be 0. So this will be 0. This will, you don't need to find here. Why do we not need to find here? Because this will give us minus 25M and Z cannot be negative. Okay, that is always positive. For maximization problem, it should be positive. So since we cannot have Z with imaginary number which is minus M, okay, because this is not required, penalty is not required. A penalty Z is not good for the solution. So we will not put anything there. Okay, so I have just simplified it. Now we need to find the most negative. So the we can see the most negative is this one. Minus 5M minus 5. What we do we need to do? We need to find theta, which is BI by AI. So how do we find it? RHS divided by the pivot column. 25 by 5 is 5. 16 by 4 is 4. 5 by 0 is not possible, which is the least positive 4. So what we will do here is we will A1 will be kept as it is. S2 will get eliminated. Instead of S2, what will enter is X2, and S3 will be as it is. Okay, this is minus M, this is 5, and this is 0. Now we will again put the simple method. It will form identity matrix 100. X2 will be 010. S3 will be 001. And this will be 0, this will be 0, and this will be 0, right? Now next thing that will come is, which is the key element? This is the key element. So what we have to do? We have to divide it by 4. So this will become 1 by 2. This will be 1. 4 by 4 is 1. 0 by 4 is 0. 1 by 4 is 1 by 4. 0 by 4 is 0. 0 by 4 is 0. 16 by 4 is 4. Right? So we need to find this. So this will be 20 minus 10. 10. 10 by 4 is 5 by 2. Right? Now 4 minus 0, 4. 4 by 4 is 1. Okay, this is ZJ minus CJ. We will find it at the end. Now what we can do is we need to find this minus 4 by minus 4 minus 0 is minus 4. Minus 4 by 4 is minus 1. 0 minus 0 is 0. Again, 0 minus 5 divided by 4, minus 5 by 4. 0 minus 0 is 0. Okay, this one will be 100 minus 80, 20. 20 by 4 is 5. 20 minus 0 by 4 is 5. So we have got some value. Now what do we need to find? We need to find this value. So minus 20M minus 4. We can see it. Minus, we are just cross multiplying. Minus 20M minus 4 plus 10M plus 5 plus 10. So what we are getting from here is minus 10M plus 6 divided by 4. So if we simplify it, this will be minus 5M plus 3. Divided by 2, right? So we need to find this 4m. 4m by 4m minus 0 divided by 4 will be m. We need to find this 0. 5m plus 5 it will become. So this is coming out to be 5m plus 5 divided by 4. We have got some value. Now we see that since all ZJ minus CJ are not positive, we need to proceed. Okay. So we will proceed with this. We need to proceed with this. So how will we proceed? Just look at this thing. So this is the most negative. So what we will do? We will divide this 5 divided by 5 by 2, so I consider it as 5 into 2 by 5, so this will be 2, 4 into 2, 8, 5 divided by 1, 5, right, so which is the least positive 2, so A1 will leave. This is very important. Whenever we get the final solution, when all Zj minus Ct are going to be positive, what is the most important thing? A should leave the equation. If A is not leaving my final iteration, then there is something wrong with the solution and I have to interpret what is that wrong thing with the solution. Because if A is there, that A will impart minus M into A value to the system, even if all Zj minus Ct are going to be positive. This will impart something to the Z max, and this will make the solution a penalty solution for the company. So we need not have A in the final iteration. So luckily we are leaving the A. So A is leaving, and what is entering? We can see what is entering. X1 is entering. So X1 will come. X2 will be there. S3 will be there. We know the value of X1, 1. X2 is 5. S3 is 0. So now we know all this thing also. What is that thing? X1 will have 100, X2 will have 010, and S3 will have 001. We'll just put it here 001. And we know Zj minus Cj of all these three will be 0. Okay, Zj minus Cj will be 0, right? Okay, now we need to find the variable, which is the key element. The key element is 5 by 2. So to make it 1, we have to multiply it by 2 by 5. This is already 1. So we need not worry. This is 0 into 2 by 5. You can see. So minus 1 into 2 by 5 is minus 2 by 5. Minus 5 by 4 into 2 by 5 will be minus 1 by 2. Right? And 1 into 2 by 5 will be 2 by 5. 5 into 2 by 5 will be 2. We have got all the value. So what do we need to find next is this value. So 0 minus half, minus minus plus half, half into 2 by 5 will be 1 by 5, correct? Now, 0 minus minus plus 1 into 2 by 5, so will be 2 by 5. Now we need to find this. So 5 by 8 plus 5 by 8, we can see 10 by 8, 5 by 4 into 2 by 5. So 5 by 4 into 2 by 5. Again, it will be 1 by 2. We can see 5 by 4 into 2 by 5. I'm just trying to simplify. I've already given you how to calculate. Okay. So what is coming out from this is 1 by 2. Okay, now we need to find this. This will be 0 plus 5 by 4, 0 plus 5 by 4, right? So 5 by, again this will be half only. Now we need to find this value. What will be this value? This way, minus half into 2 by 5, minus 1 by 5, again 0, minus 1 into 2 by 5, minus 2 by 5. We need to find this value. 5 by 2 into 4 will be 10 by 2. 20 by 2. Right? 20 by 2. Minus 5 by 2. So what is coming out from this is 15 by 2. Into 2 by 5. So if we simplify, what we'll get is 3. Right? So what I'm getting from here is 3. I'll just put that value. We have got this value to be equal to 3. Now, 25 by 2 minus 5. 25 by 2 minus 5 will be how much? 15 by 2. Correct? 15 by 2 into 2 by 5. Again, I'll get 3. So I have got all the values. I just need to check whether all these are positive or not. Even if this is not positive, we'll get to the next iteration. So we need to find all this value. So we will first find this value. So for this, we will go here. Rather than going here, since there is no A right now available, we can direct multiply from here also. Minus 2 by 5 plus 5 by 5. What is remaining is minus 2 plus 5 by 5 will be 3 by 5 into 2 by 5. Right? No, minus 3 by 5. We have got minus 2 by 5 plus 3 by 5 by 5. What is remaining is 3 by 5 minus 0. Since that is having S1 and S1 was equal to what? S1 CJ was equal to 0. So this is coming out to be 3 by 5 minus 0, which is 3 by 5. You can even do cross multiplication, you will get to the same value. Okay. Now to find this value, since this calculation is simple, so 1 into this value minus half plus 5 by 2, right? So minus half plus 5 by 2 will give me, minus half plus 5 by 2 will give me how much? Minus 1 plus 5, 4 by 2. So 4 by 2 will be 2, 2 into 2, okay. What I am getting is 2 minus again 0. So this is coming out to be 2. This is also positive, very nice. Last thing is 2 by 5 minus 1 by 5. Sorry, 2 by 5 minus 5 by 5. What I am getting from here is 2 by 5 minus 5 by 5, okay. Okay, last one will not be there. So this will be minus 3 by 5. And this is already having some variable which was, which is having which value? Minus m. So minus of minus will be plus m. So this will automatically be, if we try to simplify this, this will become 5m minus 3 by 5. Now since it is having, now you can see 5m minus 3 by 5. Now you might think that minus 3 is negative, but 5 is a very large value and it is a positive. So if this is positive, always 5m minus 3, 5m minus 3 will always be positive only. Okay. What you are getting here is 5m minus 3 by 5. So since all zj minus cj are positive, right? And no artificial, this is also important, no artificial variable in final iteration. Okay. So the solution is done. We have found the solution. Okay. All zj minus ct are positive and no artificial variable. So what we will do here is 1 into 2, we will find the x1. 1 into 2 is 2. 5 into 3 is 15. 0 into 3 is 0. So this will become 2 plus 15 is 17. What we have got? We have got some values. What are the values? Can we just list down the value? We have got x1 is equal to 2. x2 is equal to 3. z max is equal to 17. So that means, matlab what we have shown is all zj minus cj are positive. Okay, what is the condition? Zj minus cj should be positive and no artificial variable should remain. No artificial variable in final solution or final iteration. Then only we can conclude that we have got the solution. If there would have been some artificial variable, we would have incurred a penalty. And penalty is not required. Penalty cost method is like we are incurring a penalty, but we don't want the penalty, because if the penalty remains, our solution will not be a feasible solution. We incur a loss, or we will incur a huge loss to the company. Okay, so what we can see that Taylor spends 2 hours on A, atom A, and 3 hours on atom B to get profit of how many units? 17 units. Now we can do one thing. We can even solve this question by graphical method, just to make the things easy for us. We will solve this questions by graphical method also. What were our equation? Our equation was 5x1 plus 5x2 is greater than equal to 25, 2x1 plus 4x2 less than equal to 16, and there was one more, x1 less than equal to 5, and we also know that x1, x2 are greater than equal to 0. Now if we want to solve this by graphical, subjected to z, which was x1 plus 5x2. What is the condition? How do we solve graph since there are only two variables? Therefore, graphical solution is possible. OK. okay, graphical solution is possible. So if graphical solution is possible, what we will do is we will try to draw the graph for this. I'll just take a graph. I've just taken a graph. You can see I've taken a graph. What I'll do is I'll try to plot this equation. So what are my equations? Just need to see my equations. Yeah. What is my first equation? X 5x1 plus 5x2. Now inequality. So we will do 5x1 plus 5x2 is equal to 25. If you try to simplify, this will be x1 plus x2 is equal to 5. What are the coordinates? The coordinate is 5, 0 and 0, 5. Right? The coordinates will be 5, 0 and 0, 5. Suppose this is 5, 0. Okay, and similarly, this is 0, 5. So we have got two coordinates, 5, 0. And one more coordinate that we have got is 0, 5. Now one line should pass from this. We'll just take a line for our convenience. Okay, so I have just taken a line. And what I'll do is, I'll draw this line from this point. We have just got a line. Since this is greater than or less than, this is greater than, right? This is greater than. So if this is greater than, this will go away from the origin. Okay. And what is the equation of this line? I'll write the equation. You can write anything. I am just putting 5x1 plus 5x2. Since this is again going to be an inequality, I'll put it less than greater than. Sorry, at least it has been said, so it will be greater than equal to 25. Okay. Now I'll get to the second. For getting to the second, what I'll do is I'll take another color for our simplicity. What is our equation? 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 16. Now it is less than. We'll consider less than afterward. X1 plus 2x2. Is equal to 8. So what will be our coordinate? If we try to simplify, other coordinates will be, if we just try to simplify, we'll get some coordinates. What will be our coordinates? X1 by 8 plus x2 by 4 is equal to 1. So what will be our coordinate? 8, 0 and 0, 4. I'll just put it, where will be my 8? Suppose this is my 8 and this is my 0, 4. So this is 0, 4, and this coordinate I have just mentioned here is 8, 0 and 0, 4. Now what we will do is we'll just take a line. Okay, and this line should pass from this point and this point. Okay, now we also know that this line was less than equal to, right? So if this is less than equal to, this should go towards origin. So this will go towards origin. I hope you are getting this will go towards origin. And what is the equation of this line? I'll just put it. The equation of this line was 2x1 plus 4x2 less than equal to 16. So we have got two lines. The last one is, you can see this line. What is the last line? There was one more line, this. What was that line? I just need to figure out that line. X1 is less than equal to 5. So that means x1 is equal to 5 will be our line. So this will have coordinate 5, 0. Matlab it will be parallel to x2 axis. So now we know that this is my x1 axis and this will be my x2 axis. So this will be parallel at this point. So I have to take a line at this point. I'll just take a line which will be parallel from this point. Right? I'll just draw a parallel line. So you can just see I have drawn a line, and this line is also towards, so this will also be towards. And what is the equation of this line? What is the equation? This is x1 is less than equal to 5. We also know that x1 is greater than 0, equal to 0, and x2 is greater than equal to 0. So if you try to convert it, x1 will be equal to 0 and x2 will be equal to 0. X1 is equal to 0 is equation of x2 axis, right? And x2 is equal to 0 is equation of x1 axis. So equation of x1 axis will be x2 is equal to 0. And what it is being said, this is greater than 0 in the inequality. If it is greater than 0, it will go upward from both the sides, right? So if this is my line, this will go upward. And what is the second equation? X1 is great, x1 is equal to 0. So x2 is equal, wherever there is x2 axis, that will be x1 is equal to 0. And this is also greater, so this will go also right side. Whenever x2 is greater than 0, this will go upward. Whenever x1 is greater than 0, this will shift towards the right side. So the common region, this is going upward, right? This both things are going upward. This is going right. So the common region out of this will be first quadrant. So what we'll get is first quadrant. And we will try to find common. This is going, this line is going downward, right? This line is going this side. This line is going this line. This line is also going this one. Where is this? Yeah, this line is going upward. Okay, and this line is going this. So we can find this will be R. This point, this region will be the common region. This region will be called as R feasible region. So we have got some points at the end of the feasible region. We need to evaluate the corner points. Okay, now how to evaluate the corner points? Now we need to find the corner points. We can see that this corner point, I'll just take different color. So we already know that this corner point is 5, 0. We need to find this corner point. So this corner point is an intersection of two lines. Which are those two lines? So I'll just put it for you. What are those two lines? One is x is equal to 5, right? And the another line is, which is intersecting this, is this line. You can see this line, right? So this line is having some equation. Which was that equation? 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 16. So this will be, this is 5. So this will be 10. 16 minus 10 will be equal to 6. So x2 will be equal to how much? X2 will be equal to 6 by 4 is 3 by 2. So I've got this coordinate as one coordinate corner point. Corner points coordinate I need to find. So the corner points coordinate, one of the coordinate is 5, 0. Another coordinate is 5, 3 by 2. Okay, we need to find the one more coordinate. So what will be that one more coordinate? For that we need to see the graph again. This point, so this will be an intersection of two lines. One is 5x1 plus 5x2 is equal to 25, which is nothing but x1 plus x2 is equal to 5, right? And the another equation is 2x1 plus 4x2. If we simplify that equation, 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 16. So that will be nothing but x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 8. What we will do is we will solve those equations. What is this equation? x1 plus x2 is equal to 5. x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 8. So we will just subtract this thing. So what I'll get from this after subtraction, what I'll get from here is x2 is equal to 3. And if x2 is equal to 3, x1 will be equal to 2. So I've got one more point, 2, 3. So what was z? I just need to write 5, 0. I'll just put it in a simple form for you. What are my corner points? 5, 0. 3, 5/2, right? And one more that I got is 2, 3. And what is my z? Z is equal to x1 plus 5x2. I'll just find it. We need to maximize. Okay, so first one will be 5. Second one will be 3 plus 2 is again 3 plus 5 into 5/2. Matlab 3 plus 25/2. Matlab we are getting around 15.5. And the last one will be again 17. So this was the answer that we got by simplex method also. Okay, so we have measured the answer that it will require 2 hours of this and 3 hours of atom B, okay, and 2 hours of atom A and 3 hours of atom B to get a maximum profit of how many units? 17 units, right? Thank you so much.